Delicious.
Big Bird story time.
Hi, I'm glad you're here because it's story time. Big Bird's here, and Snuffy's here, and now you're here too.
That's right. Maria's going to read to Snuffy and me before we take our little naps, huh?
Okay, you're all set, aren't you?
Oh, sure. I got my blanket.
And I have my blanket, too.
Okay.
And I got my radar.
Yep.
It's a teddy bear.
And I've got Mr. Antelope.
Mm-hmm.
And look, I even have some bird seed in case I need a little snack while you're reading.
Okay.
And I brought along a little snack, too.
Okay, so where's the storybook?
Beg your pardon?
Well, the storybook. I can't read a story to you without a storybook.
Oh, my goodness. Of course. Oh, well, gee. Snuffy and I have to run down to the library for a second. Would you mind waiting here, Maria? Come on, Snuff. We gotta hurry.
Okay, Blue.
After you, my dear Alfonso.
Yep.
Well, don't go away, because as soon as they're back, I'll read a story for them, and for you, too.
I wonder if they have any books in this library that might be interesting to a grouch.
Books interesting to a grouch?
You want to know if there might be books interesting to a grouch?
Oh, no, not you two guys again.
I'm Gilbert, and I know all about grouches.
And I'm Sullivan, and I know all about what's in a library.
Yeah, but you guys always tell me too much about everything. All I said was...
Shh. We'll tell you all about it.
Oh, good grief. Here they go again.
There's books for him and books for her and books for you and me. You'll find good books for everyone at your library.
I love a good adventure book with swordsmen, knights, and duels.
And I love books of animals like bunnies, cows, and newels.
Please spare me all your action books or kangaroos with pouches. What I am really looking for are books designed for grouches.
There are books about music and books about dance.
And how about a travel book? Far away lands, full of jungles and mountains and hot desert sands.
And how about a mystery book, detectives, cops, and spies?
Well, I prefer a cooking book with salads, cakes, and pies.
I do not care for travel books or books on cooking hash. If you don't mind, please point me to the books that deal with trash.
Sing yo ho ho for a song about the sea, for a sailor on the ocean is the thing I want to be.
What?
I said... Sing yo ho ho for a song about the sea, for a sailor on the ocean is the thing I wanna be.
Oh, very good, my boy.
A book on baseball, football, and lots of other games. All the scores and all the players, both their numbers and their names.
I don't care about the ocean or the 100-meter dash. Please won't someone find for me the books that deal with trash.
About buses and books about cars.
There are books about planets and books about stars.
There are books about fishing for tuna and bass And how to plant flowers instead of just grass.
There are books about people like statesmen and kings.
And how about inventors who think up new things?
There are books about sewing and science and art. There's so much I sometimes don't know where to start.
There are books about treasures that long ago sunk.
But you still haven't shown me the books about junk.
Don't yell, don't scream, don't start to steam, don't make an angry face, oh. If you want trash, don't shout as trash, you only have to say so. If you will face in this direction, there's our special Grouch's section.
Wow! I'm in heaven!
As we said before, a library's a place where if you take your eyes and look, you'll find whatever you're seeking in a magazine or book. There's books for him and books for her and books for you and me. You'll find good books for everyone at your library.
La 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 la, la 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 la.
Will you people please pipe down? I'm trying to read. This is a library.
You'll find good books for everyone at your library.
Here they come.
Come on, Snap. You can get
careful
through.
Careful now. Careful.
One little push. Here you go. Yeah, I knew he could do it.
Attaboy.
Gee, Maria, you know, we got all the way down to the library, and it was closed.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but we just stopped at Mr. Hooper's store, and we bought a newspaper for you to read to us.
Oh.
Snuffy has it in his mouth.
Oh.
He wanted to carry it like a dog does.
Womp, womp.
The Sesame Street News.
Yeah.
Business section?
Oh, boring.
Okay, sports section.
No.
Oh, here it is, a fairy tale section.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Oh, here's something about the Princess Rapunzel.
Oh, really?
Do you remember her? Hmm. She was the one that got captured by a wicked witch.
And put her in a tower?
Put her in a tower, locked her in a tower, and then a handsome prince came to the tower and asked her to let down her hair. Remember? Mm-hmm. And it was so long, he was able to climb up her hair and help her get out of the tower. Do you remember, Big Bird?
I remember.
Yes. Well, there's a story about it right here, and it says, a reporter from this paper went out to the tower to see how the rescue plan was progressing.
Hi all, this is Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, and today I am standing at the base of the tower where the Princess Rapunzel is being held prisoner by the Wicked Witch.
Get me out of here!
Now that, as you can probably tell, is the Princess Rapunzel. Now you can tell that's Rapunzel because she has such fantastically long hair. Now the Princess Rapunzel has the longest hair in the entire kingdom. And today, we're awaiting the arrival of Prince Charming, who's due to rescue her at any instant. Matter of fact, I think I hear a horse approaching now.
Easy, big fellow.
That sort of looks like it might be Prince Charming.
All right.
Sounds like his horse will...
Sit, boy. Good boy.
See if this is him. Yes, that really looks like Prince Charming. Pardon me, sir. Can you tell me, are you really indeed Prince Charming?
Of course.
Yes, and you're here to rescue the Princess Rapunzel, is that right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Where is she?
She's right up in the tower there.
My love!
Isn't that beautiful? Pardon me, Prince. Can you tell me, do you have a plan to rescue this Princess Rapunzel?
Yes.
Would you mind telling us what your plan is?
Yes.
You do mind. Won't tell us.
Go away.
I see he does not want to divulge the plan, but we'll just find out.
Please.
Of course, Prince. Certainly. Carry on. Go right ahead. We'll just talk very quietly.
Please.
Right. Okay. Yes. Yes.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair.
Aha, aha. See, that's what the plan is. He's asking the princess to lower her hair, and she's probably going to let her hair down, and then the prince will climb up the hair and
Frog.
Affect the rest. Excuse me.
Frog.
Right, sorry. Carry on. Don't mean to interrupt there.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair.
What'd you say? I can't hear you. Can you talk louder?
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair. Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your hair!
My hair?
Your hair, yes!
You want me to let down my hair?
You got it! Down here!
Oh, okay!
Your hair!
Yeah, sure!
Now!
Hey, Prince, now what, huh? What do I do now?
I don't know. I'll leave it with the frog!
But wait a second.
He's right there!
I don't think this is the way the story is supposed to... Listen, this is Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, returning you now to your regularly scheduled program.
I lost my horse.
He was
over... Oh, wow, look. Here's something about an accident.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. The headline says, Dumpty Tumbles. Oh, this is about Humpty Dumpty. Remember him?
Yeah, Humpty Dumpty. He was the one that sat on the wall.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall.
Humpty Dumpty had a great fall.
All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. Yeah. That's right.
So.
Let's see. It says here, Humpty Dumpty, that egg we all know and love, fell off a wall today.
Again.
Our reporter went down to the wall to get the latest on Mr. Dumpty's condition.
Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the scene of the accident, where Mr. Humpty Dumpty has just fallen off of his wall. And to recapitulate that story, you may remember that Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall, and Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. And all of the king's horses, and all of the king's men, and, wait a minute, that's one of the king's cows back there. Pardon me, cow, I believe it's just supposed to be all the king's horses here. Come on, get out, get out, get out. All the king's horses and all the king's men are indeed trying to put Mr. Humpty Dumpty back together again, and we're going to get a word in with one of the king's horses here right now. Pardon me, horse. Kermit the Frog here, Sesame Street News. Can you tell us just what's happening with Mr. Dumpty over there?
Well, Dumpty's a tough egg.
Yeah, tough
not
egg,
what you'd
yeah.
call hard-boiled or anything.
Hard-boiled,
but
right.
But he had a pretty bad fall.
Bad fall,
yeah,
you say?
Yeah, you could see part of him over there.
Yes, that's part. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's another part of him.
Gotcha, another
yeah,
part.
And right there, that's the final part right there. That's the last of him.
Yes, I see.
Yep, well, I gotta get back to work, Frog.
Okay, well, thank you. Well, folks, as you can see, it's been a bad break for Mr. Humpty Dumpty, but the delicate job of putting him back together again has started. Matter of fact, if you look back there now, you can see that they've got the bottom and middle parts together. Yeah, and right there, see that? There comes the top part right now. This is a very exciting and dramatic moment, friends. And matter of fact, there it is. They've got Mr. Humpty Dumpty back together again.
Yay!
Oh, look at that, friends. Look at that, friends. Humpty Dumpty is back together again.
Yes, I am.
Listen, Kermit the Frog here of Sesame Street News here.
Hi, Frog.
Yes, well, I just wanted to ask you...
Oh, Sesame Street, how do I look?
You look fine, yeah.
Thank you.
And I just wanted to ask you, how does it feel to have it all together again, huh?
Well, golly, I just feel like a brand new person.
Well, you certainly look like one. And speaking for all the egg lovers of the country, I want you to know it's very nice to have you back. Horses, king's men.
Oh, no.
I'm awfully sorry about that.
Some story, huh? Oh, hey, here's something weird. Witch talks to mirror.
Really?
Yeah. It says here, the witch from the story about Snow White bought herself a mirror. She hung it up in her castle, and castle sources say they've seen her talking to it.
That is weird.
It says here, a reporter went to the witch's castle to check it out. continued on page, oh, yes.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here, and today I'm speaking to you from the magic mirror room of the Wicked Witch. And we understand that the Wicked Witch is on her way here. She's expected shortly, and she plans to ask her magic mirror a very important question. And standing next to me now is the mirror to which the witch will address that question. Pardon me, come in, magic mirror, please. Sure. Good heavens. Excuse me, mirror, but do you happen to know what question the witch will be asking you, please, sir?
Of course. Hmm? The same question she always asks
me. And what is that question, please, sir?
Who's the fairest of them all?
And do you know what you're going to reply to that, sir?
I always reply honestly, of course.
Good.
Snow White.
And how does the witch react when you tell her that, please, sir?
It drives her up the wall, Froggy.
That's the way the story goes, folks. Oops, matter of fact, I think the witch is coming now. I think I must betake myself to a place of concealment.
Ah, mirror, I'm gonna get you this time. Let's see, is Mike working here? Testing 1, 2, okay. Mirror, mirror, come in, mirror, over.
Mirror here.
All right, mirror, mirror, on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
That's the question, folks. We all know what's going to happen next, don't we?
Mm-hmm. And?
Hold it, she's changing the question.
Who's the fairest of them all and is wearing a hat, has 2 beautiful eyes, is green, is in the same room with you right now, and is holding a microphone.
Wow, this is certainly very clever of the witch, because the mirror cannot possibly answer Snow White, because Snow White doesn't have all that stuff.
Who's the fairest of them all? Is
right.
Wearing a hat.
Right here, kid.
Has 2 beautiful eyes.
Look at these, baby.
Is green. Is in the same room with me right now and is holding a microphone.
Lay it on me, baby.
Kermit the Frog.
Me?
Wah!
Me? I'm the fairest? Oh, really? Thank you.
You know what?
This is Kermit the Fair Frog.
He is kind of cute.
Returning you to your regularly scheduled program.
Oh, huh? Those are sweet flippers. Where'd you get them?
Thank you.
Glad I don't have a mirror like that.
Yeah. And did you notice that there's only one reporter on this whole newspaper? I mean, every time something happens, he has to be the one to go down and check it out. Did you notice that, Snuffy? Snuffy? Hey, Snuffy. Well, I was just going to say that it's fun to listen to stories, especially because while you're listening, you can imagine what it's like to be a witch or a princess or an egg.
You woke him up to tell him that.
Of course, Maria. I mean, if I tried to tell him while he was sleeping, he never would have heard me.
Makes sense to me, Bird.
Sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a knight in shining armor in a castle by the sea. A knight in shining armor with a princess by my side. I'd have a magic feather and a horse that I could ride. And the king would say,
Sir Ernie, you're so handsome and so brave. Please rid us of this dragon breathing fire in his cave.
And I'd get on my horse and I'd start to ride. I'd travel my way through the countryside. I'd come at last to the dragon's cave and I'd yell, Mr. Dragon, you better behave! And the dragon would be so scared of me that he'd run away. And the kingdom would be free. And I'd dip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Imagine that. Sometimes
times I imagine that I would like to be a daring, bold explorer sailing far across the sea. I'd set out on a sailing ship to find a distant land. I'd gaze across the ocean with my telescope in hand. And the captain would say,
Ernie, there's a big storm drawing near. You're our finest, bravest sailor. You must grab the wheel and steer.
And I'd grab the wheel in the wind and rain. I'd steer the ship through the hurricane. I'd guide the ship with a steady hand. I'd lead the way toward a brand new land. I'd spy the land lying safe and near. And I'd cry, land ho! And the crew would cheer. And I'd tip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that.
Yep.
Sometimes I imagine that I would like to be a person whose name Ernie, who looks quite a lot like me, who likes the things that I like and who does the things I do. And I don't have to imagine, because I'm Ernie. Me. That's who. And I tip my hat. Imagine that. Imagine that. Imagine that.
I wonder if there's anything in that newspaper about the story of the three... Oh, you know, the three animals.
What animals?
Oh, the story about the three animals. I forget what you call them.
Do you mean the three little kittens?
No, they're bigger than kittens.
How about the three billy goats, Gruff?
Nope.
Oh, you must mean the story of Goldilocks and the three bears.
That might be it.
Mm-hmm.
How does that story go again?
It goes like this. Once upon a time, there were three bears. A father bear, a mother bear, and a baby bear. And they lived in the woods.
In the woods?
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. Yeah. Okay, I got it. Go on.
Well, one day, the three bears decided to go for a walk. And while they were gone, Goldilocks wandered into their house.
I can see it now. Goldilocks wandered into the three bears' house.
In the house, she saw three bowls on the table. She tasted the father bears and said, "This is too hot." She tasted the mother bears and said, "This is too cold." She tasted the baby bears and said, "This is just right," and she ate it all up. Well, she walked into the living room and saw three chairs. She sat on the father's chair and said, "This is too hard." She sat on the mother's chair and said, "This is too soft." She sat on the baby's chair and said, "This is just right." But she sat down with such a thud that she broke it into a zillion pieces. Well, then she went upstairs and saw three beds. Well, she lay on the father's bed and said, "This is too wide." Then she lay on the mother's bed and said, "This is too narrow."
Well, wait a minute, wait a minute. Well, what's narrow?
Well, it just means that she didn't fit into it.
All right, I got it. Go ahead.
Well, then she lay on the baby's bed, and it was just right. It was so right that she fell asleep. Just then, the three bears came home, and the father bear said, "Somebody's been eating out of my bowl." And the mother bear said, somebody's been eating out of my bowl. And the baby bear said, somebody's been eating out of my bowl and ate it all up. Then they went into the living room. And the father bear said, somebody's been sitting in my chair. And the mother bear said, somebody's been sitting in my chair. And the baby bear said, somebody's been sitting in my chair, and they broke it into a zillion pieces. Then they went upstairs. And the father bear said, somebody's been sleeping in my bed. And the mother bear said, somebody's been sleeping in my bed. And the baby bear said, somebody's been sleeping in my bed, and there she is. Well, this woke Goldilocks up, and she jumped out of bed and ran down the stairs and out of the house and all the way home to her mother and father. The end.
That was a nice story, Maria. But it wasn't the story I had in mind. No, the three little animals I was thinking of was the three little pigs. That's right, I remember.
Oh, the three little pigs, yes. Yeah. Well, let's see. If there's anything about the three little pigs in here. Here's something about the three little pigs. It says, the three little pigs had been fine and living in their homes in Teaneck until today, when a wolf came and blew two of their houses down.
Hi there, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News, reporting to you today from the house of the three little pigs. And today we're expecting the big bad wolf to drop around. But first, Hark, I believe this is one of the three little pigs here. Pardon me, pig. Hmm? Excuse me. Can I ask you, Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News? Can I ask you a question or two? For instance, could you tell me what this house is built of?
Straw.
Uh-huh.
Straw.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Well, could you tell us exactly why you built your house out of straw?
Because straw is light and easy to carry, and when we get hungry, we can nibble on a wall or two, even. Yeah.
Well, don't you think it would have been better to build a house out of wood or bricks or something like that?
Right.
In case somebody like, maybe a big bad wolf were to come along and huff and puff and blow the house down?
Blow this house down?
Yeah, well,
I worked 4 days on this house. This is a strong house.
Yeah, but
blow this house down?
Well,
blow this house down? Oh, I gotta tell the guys that. That's a good one.
Well, he was.
Tis to laugh.
He seems to take the whole subject rather lightly, but hark. What do I see coming now?
I'm gonna cook you.
It's a large, shaggy thing. Pardon me, but are you indeed the big bad wolf himself?
Oh, I am indeed.
Can you tell me exactly what you had in mind coming around here today?
Oh, yeah. Well, you see, this is where the three little pigs live.
True.
Yeah, and I got some business with them, because I'm gonna make them an offer they can't refuse.
Yeah, well, do you mind if we from Sesame Street stand around to watch?
Okay, but you better stand back.
Okay, I'll just go right over here on this tree.
Little pig, open the door.
Wait a minute. Hold on, just 1 second. Just a minute. There's a tradition here. The big bad wolf is supposed to say, little pig, let me come in.
Oh, yeah.
That's the line, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. Little pig, let me come in.
Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
Somehow I thought he would say that.
Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
Stand by, folks. Here it comes. folks. And Wolf is huffing and puffing, and it's really quite a, good heavens, it's quite a breeze he's got going here. We'll see if he's able to blow the house down here. He's really blowing hard. You talk about a strong breath, folks. My heavens. Wolf is still blowing, and so this is Kermit the Frog, and the wolf is now returning me to Sesame Street.
Okay, that's enough stories for today. It's time for your nap. Mwah. You guys have a good rest. And you have a good rest, too.
Thanks for the stories, Maria.
Whoosh, that's been a busy day. Hey, you guys mind if I join you? Move over there. That's good.
Have a nice snooze, Kermit.